what is going on in your life. So, with your attention.
Opportunities, that's what happens when it becomes a business. I know there's a couple girls in the audience who can really the coach advisory board, kind of at the height of my Beachbody career, and we went into 15-star qualifying, almost made it so close through that qualification. And like I said, it was like I was at the height of my business. I couldn't get, I mean, it could only go up from here, you know. It was just like, it was amazing, and it still is, but I'm going to kind of take you to another part of my business that I don't get to share that much, and I'm excited to share this topic with you guys, so we can change the slide. talked a little bit about quarterly bonuses earlier. So Craig said, hey, Stephanie, I just wanted to let you know that you're one elite point shy of getting your quarterly bonus. I was like, super pissed. It was like the last day. And that was kind of the final straw for me. And I thought, I'm tired of telling the same story that I'm broken. I'm too broken. I'm too far behind now. Maybe I just got lucky in the beginning and, you know, my success was a fluke. I'm tired of telling myself that while I know that depression and anxiety are real, that I was letting that define me so much that I wasn't stronger than those stories that I was telling myself. And I don't know if you guys follow Tony Robbins, but divorce your story and marry the truth. I always know that one. That was kind of what I did. I was like, I'm just tired of this same story. I'm tired of being the girl who starts over, who can't get her you-know-what together, who's behind, who can't get 20 SC points a month, because I told myself, well, I'm not a big numbers person. And we'll get to those stories next. But I became a student, and so I'm going to share a couple of ideas and tools that I use to really just get my hands dirty again and dive in, because you can imagine, social media is changing all the time. I don't know about you guys, but I build my business almost 100%, well, definitely 100% on social media. But social media is always changing. Algorithms change, styles change, and so I decided, instead of watching, you know, maybe top leaders who are great to get motivation and inspiration from, I started watching people outside of Beachbody, and I started watching what was really popular and getting killer likes and tons of engagement on Instagram. If you guys are on Instagram, you need to be. And that's where I was gaining my inspiration. And it was kind of a build. I kind of recrafted my Instagram, really dove into using Instagram stories, doing the things that made me feel a little bit uncomfortable, being more intentional and styled with my photos. And that's not for everybody. I know that some people do an amazing job of really like on-the-fly posting and selfies and things like that. But for me, the style that really like spoke to me and inspired me was really curated styles and feeds. So I wanted to emulate that. After Summit, I bought a preset. You guys can get them anywhere. So I started using a preset, which is like a filter on all of my pictures on Instagram. I started to develop kind of a style. I used apps like Planoly. We say it differently, Liz and I. I love that app. For me, with four kids, busy schedule, kids in sports and all of that, we all know that really good posting traffic times on social media is like, you know, that 5:30 to 7:30 window in the evening. That's dinner time, right? Moms. That's just a really busy time of the evening. So Planoly. P-L-A-N-O-L-Y. Use it. Love it. There's also the Preview app, and I guess my sister-in-law told me about one called Later. So these are tools that you can use not only to curate your feed, so you can see what your future posts are going to look like in your feed, because remember that Instagram is very aesthetic, it's very visual, it's very instant. Somebody's going to come to your feed and immediately judge you, honestly, on probably the first few rows. And if it's not pretty and it's not eye-catching, there's a million other accounts that they're going to go and follow. And I'm sorry if that sounds harsh, but it's true. So I use apps like that so that I can see what my feed is going to look like ahead of time. And then I schedule my posts. So most of my posts, can you guys hear me? I feel like it keeps going in and out. Most of my posts are scheduled. Apps like Planoly, like my auto schedule. Sometimes, depending on the file size, it'll send me a prompt. It can't auto-post it, Instagram rules, things like that. But anyway, great tools. I use Lightroom app to filter, to put the preset on my pictures. You guys can, like I said, get a preset from anywhere. Etsy sells them. You can find them on Instagram. There's instructions that come with the preset so that you know how to upload it into the app. Very self-explanatory. Little learning curve in the beginning, but now I love it. There's also VSCO Cam, which is another great preset or filter app. When you're not having to filter it and take all this time to, you know, edit your pictures and figure photo shoot at Scottsdale Border in the middle of the day when all the workers are walking by and you're wearing your sports bras. Like, awkward at all. But outdoor lighting is key. Just anything pretty. And you will find those accounts, whether it's maybe a fashion blogger or if it's a foodie page or whatever your vibe is, if you're like a dog mom or you're a runner, you love food pics, you love to cook, go find accounts like that and follow them for inspiration. I feel like I could do like a whole social media thing, but I'm not gonna. So that's where I just became a student of social media. I relearned it because when I was a new coach, it was all Facebook, and I really had to make that shift. Help. guys to go home tonight and sit down and write down five stories that you tell yourselves that you can change, that you can physically change. Obviously, if it's like you have a heart condition, okay, maybe you cannot change that like that. So there are things, obviously, that we can't change about ourselves, but the things that you can change, I want you guys to write them down, and I want you to really think long and hard about what you can do this week to change those stories. And it's a decision. It really is. When you make that decision, it changes everything.